we'll just see if we can run this through.
Hello, sweetheart, you're right.
Court, today is a really, really important day because basically I'm cooking for JK and all the boys from the band Jamiroquai, yeah? And they've just finished their album, so they want a bit of a celebration, and I am doing the food! And they've always been my favourite band, so, you know, it's a bit special, yeah? I've got all my clobber here, got my tables, got my pots, my pans, I've got all my food all wrapped up, bagged up, ready to go. How good am I, mate, eh?
It's Jamie.
Hello, you must
hello.
Be Di.
Yeah, it's very nice to meet you. Jay's just in the studio, rehearsing. Right. Do you want to come say hello?
Love to.
Cool.
How's it going?
It's going very well.
Who's going to be cooking dinner for the band tonight?
All right, boys. Yeah, good. Are you all right?
How's it going?
Yeah, good, mate.
Wicked. Rob, guitar.
How you doing,
Nick,
mate? All right.
Bass.
Hello, Nick.
Shola, who likes cake.
Who likes cake?
Cake.
Lots of...
You're right,
Derek. Hello, mate.
Toby.
I've heard about you.
Simon. Superb.
So what's going on, then?
I don't know. I'm waiting for my dinner.
Are you going to show me where everything is? Or should I?
Yeah, what would you like to see?
Kitchen will be up.
Okay. Now, my kitchen's small. It's not like yours. All right? It isn't like yours. It's a small kitchen. It's a humble kitchen. It's got an auger in there. I don't know how you feel about it.
You got an auger?
I have got an auger, yeah.
You come in.
And can you sort yourself out in here? Is
yeah.
that going to be a problem?
What's this, mate?
There, underneath that. Underneath this line of the tap-in hall.
Japanese styling.
Yeah, Japanese styling.
Fantastic.
This is sort of
yeah,
the dust.
You've used it a lot, haven't you? Jamie Oliver was here. Go on, mate. Get back to your rehearsal. I'll clean it.
Bye then.
See you later. Cool is this place, eh? A fantastic gaff. I'm just going to kind of get myself sorted out. I'm going to do dessert first. Basically, what I'm going to do is a really sort of nice pine nut and honey tart, which is sort of like Moroccanish in vibe. I need a fork. Ah, I haven't brought a fork. Oh, no, that's a dish. here we go. Lucky call. I've made some shortcrust pastry, yeah? Sweet shortcrust pastry.
How do you feel about pre-made pastry?
To be honest, if it's like just for dinner, me and my missus, a couple of friends, I just go and get a bit of pre-made, knock it out in the mould, straight in the oven, you're laughing. But you know, special occasions and stuff, you want to sort of like do the real McCoy. And I lined this tart ring, 12-inch tart ring, and then I froze it. That means that when you put it into the oven, it doesn't shrink down. And what happens is when this starts cooking, the heat kind of gets under here, and it starts sort of bulbing up a little bit here. So if you just prick it around, then it lets the air out. So I'm going to pop this in the oven at about 170, 180 for about sort of 10 minutes until it's just cooked but not coloured. So to do the filling, the first thing I have to do, you need 250 grams of pine nuts. They're 100 gram a packet, so 2.5 of these. And I just want to sort of like lightly toast these. And the thing is, I'm a nightmare with nuts. I'm always like burning the hell out of them. So I'm going to pop that in a hot oven. I just want to give them like 2 minutes. And then I've got some butter, yeah, 250 grams, which is basically a pack. And I need 250 grams of sugar, right? Butter and sugar together. I just want a pinch of salt. Also, four tablespoons of honey. Use the best honey you can get. You generally get what you pay for, but you can get some nice sort of lavender honey, thyme honey. Doesn't matter if it's thick or clear. And four. And you kind of want to cream it. Oh, my son. Basically, you're getting the butter and the sugar, and you're making it really light and fluffy, which is going to make it rise a little bit as well. So once you've done that, I've got three whole eggs going in, but one by one. Can you imagine? Lovely. Then we stop it. All right, what we're going to do is we need to get the flour in, 115 grams of plain flour, just to sort of bind it all together. And as soon as it's come together, stop. And that's it. Don't want to whip it anymore. Just sort of... I should do this in a bowl, really, but I can't really be bothered, and I don't want to do the washing up, so get rid of that. Let me just check my pine nuts. Oh! Ah. Oh, I just caught those. I told you what I'm like. You didn't remind me either, did you? I've got some thyme. This is an optional extra, but I think it goes fantastically, you know, honey, pine nuts, and just sort of pick the tips off and put it in. Just like a little handful. And then I got an orange. Get a grater. Again, like the orange, just the zest alone, not no juice or nothing, sort of just gives it a really, really awesome flavour. And I've got the pine nuts. And you just want to kind of slowly stir that together. So, oh, just check my... Yeah, look at this. So, that's nice. Sometimes if there's some nice plums, apricots, strawberries, anything like that, really, just whack it in. Just cut them in half or something, destone them, and push them in like that, and then they'll just cook up a treat. And that's it. That's all you have to do. Just whack this in the oven. So you want it 170, about 35 minutes until it's nice and golden top, and sort of just cooked and sort of soft and nice, you know? Bob's your uncle. That's perfect, yeah? It's had about, like, 37 minutes, which means it's sort of nice and golden on top, a little bit soft in the middle. The nice thing about desserts, you can do them in the morning, right? Have them hanging around all day, and then they're always nice at sort of room temperature, and tuck into them whenever you like. And like that, with a little bit of creme fraiche or ice cream or some fruit, be really nice. Superb.